Hello friends, next topic is BNF notation. BNF stands for Backus Nor Form. It is nothing, it's just a notation technique. It is a notation technique which is used for context-free grammar. So, to represent the context-free grammar, we have a notation called as a BNF notation, which is called as Backus Nor Form. This notation is useful for specifying the syntax of the language. So this is used for specifying the syntax of the language. Okay. Then it can be notation can be expressed as symbol colon equals to expression 1 or expression 2 or expression 3 and so on. Okay, where symbols are non-terminal. Okay, and these expression 3 are called sequence of symbols. Sequence of symbol, and this symbol can be a combination of terminal as well as non-terminal. For example, in our previous video, we take some more examples of a grammar called as S derives A B A, B derives B B or epsilon, and A derives A or B. See here, this symbol can be a non-terminal, which we can represent it as S, B, and A. These expressions, expression 1, expression 2, and expression 3, which are a sequence of symbol, which is a combination of terminal and non-terminal. For example, small a, capital B, capital A, small b, capital B, and epsilon, or small a and small b. So, this is the representation of a grammar, and this representation is called as a BNF form. Okay. So, it has some rules where we already discussed, but just see some rules of BNF notation. That first is, that the optional symbols are written within square bracket. So with symbols, those symbols which are optional, we can write it down in the square brackets. Two is that for repeating the symbol for zero or more time, we can represent it by asterisk. Okay, then if we want to repeat the symbol for at least one or more time, we can represent it by plus. Okay, for example, we have a AB call asterisk. So we have asterisk, in place of asterisk, we put any number including zero. And if we read it AB plus, then it means that this string can be encountered any number of time excluding zero. Okay. Then fourth is that the alternative rules are separated by vertical bar. For example, this B production have more choice, one or more choice, and we can separated it out, these production, by a vertical bar. And the last rule is that the group of items must be enclosed within brackets. So these are some simple rules which we can represent, which we can use while representing some notation or representation of context-free grammar. Okay. So I hope you understand the BNF notation. Thanks for watching.